This is an emergency broadcast to all citizens.
Increasing areas of forest are being engulfed by flames. The thick smoke rising from the fire makes the air dangerous to breathe. Citizens are advised to vacate any premises near the fires and remain at a safe distance until emergency services manage to get the fires under control.
Second Moon Radio with your host, J. Thomas Hornbuckle. Tune in tomorrow for a second chance to hear the music of yesteryear.
A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Glenda. But apparently that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage going to make me richer?
By certain metrics, perhaps yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human
psyche. Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
This just in from traffic. If you're thinking about hitting the streets, you can expect delays on the major roads, especially during rush hour.
Good to know, Jim. Seems like everyone is in a hurry to get somewhere fast. It's worth slowing down. And if you can, plan your trip outside the rush.
Oh, I don't know. I'd rather wait an hour in traffic than to have to start thinking about everything all the time. Besides, if I did that, I'd never get anywhere.
Thank you. A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
This is Second Moon with J. Thomas Hornbuckle. Before we dive into our next selection, I'd like to take a few memento moris to elaborate on the formal structure of the symphonic work. For our newer, less able listeners, first, we will be dancing through the al dente section before entering the slower largo movement, finally, then savoring the vivacious antipasto movement. So, without further ado, let's raise the curtain and begin.
Interesting news from the city's export division. Sources tell us that our city has more services than we know what to do with.
And you know what that means, folks. It means we're not cutting things close enough.
Well, no. The point is we're selling it and bringing money into local economy.
That's right. You could almost say it's too much of a good thing.
Or we could say that we're enjoying a positive trade balance and the economy is booming. More after this.
And on to our main feature story. The commercial district is booming, as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Java mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jim. We'll be back after this.
Thank you.
You're back with Second Moon Radio, your second musical home from home. So settle back in your chair, pour yourself a glass, and prepare for another hour of musical delight. Tonight we are doing a musical tour of Italia, land of art and culture. Que bon, as they say. And an aria inspired by the infamous Vivaldi shall be our guide.
Industry in the region is on the rise, and when business is doing well, that floats our boat.
There's no sinking this boat, Glenda. We're live, and we're getting reports about a traffic accident somewhere in the city.
Road maintenance services have already been dispatched, and traffic flow should return to normal. But if you're planning a quick trip out, you might want to wait a little while until everything clears up.
If you're in it, You already know about it. No use reminding you. Meanwhile, expect delays and drive safe.
Recent spikes in demand have led to temporary local shortages in the city's fresh water supply. The public should be aware that we are struggling to get the situation in hand. This has been a local public service announcement. Pending updates to our power grid, the city will be experiencing rolling blackouts. We urge the public to remain calm during these breaks in service and to follow the guidelines on the city's website on how to plan for these temporary events. This has been a local public service announcement.
Second Moon Radio with your host, J. Thomas Hornbuckle. Tune in tomorrow for a second chance to hear the music of yesteryear.
For our feature story this hour, we're going live to Kim, who is downtown investigating the story behind our declining commercial zones. So, what exactly is driving this sudden downswing in business? Kim?
Good question, Glenda. I'm standing outside what used to be one of the busiest stores in the city. Not long ago, it would open its doors to lines of customers 7 days a week. Now the place is shuttered, like most of the commercial buildings on this once thriving city block. And the question on everybody's mind, how could it have come to this?
Thanks, Kim. We'll have more with Kim after the break. A housing shortage is driving up prices in the area.
That's right, Glenda. But apparently, that's not all good news. We're joined today by an expert guest, Professor Nutbutter.
Welcome, Professor. So a housing shortage is bad for the people trying to move here, right?
Humans are programmed to desire certain representations within ideological reward structures, which are entirely apart from the actual rewards enjoyed. For example, consider capital.
One final question, Professor. Is the housing shortage going to make me richer?
By certain metrics, perhaps yes, in the short term.
I like the sound of that.
But what we are discussing is the study of a statistical abstraction and its effect on the human
psyche. Thank you, Professor.
It is a question of priorities.
Thank you.
A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive, and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
This is Second Moon with J. Thomas Hornbuckle. Before we dive into our next selection, I'd like to take a few memento moris to elaborate on the formal structure of the symphonic work. For our newer, less able listeners, first, we will be dancing through the al dente section before entering the slower largo movement, finally, then savoring the vivacious antipasto movement. So, without further ado, let's raise the curtain and begin.
This just in from traffic. If you're thinking about hitting the streets, you can expect delays on the major roads, especially during rush hour.
Good to know, Jim. Seems like everyone is in a hurry to get somewhere fast. It's worth slowing down. And if you can, plan your trip outside the rush.
Oh, I don't know. I'd rather wait an hour in traffic than to have to start thinking about everything all the time. Besides, if I did that, I'd never get anywhere.
Interesting news from the city's export division. Sources tell us that our city has more services than we know what to do with.
And you know what that means, folks. It means we're not cutting things close enough.
Well, no. The point is we're selling it and bringing money into local economy.
That's right. You could almost say it's too much of a good thing.
Or we could say that we're enjoying a positive trade balance and the economy is booming. More after this.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're listening to Second Moon Radio with J. Thomas Hornbuckle, and we're pervading some of the finest classical music on the air. Keep that dial right here.
And on to our main feature story. The commercial district is booming, as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Java mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jimmy. We'll be back after this.
We're live, and we're getting reports about a traffic accident somewhere in the city.
Road maintenance services have already been dispatched, and traffic flow should return to normal. But if you're planning a quick trip out, you might want to wait a little while until everything clears up.
If you're in it, you already know about it. No use reminding you. Meanwhile, expect delays and drive safe.
Thank you.
A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
Has anyone seen my keys? My keys! What? We're on the air?
Sorry about that. It's nothing important. I just lost my keys. I'm sure they'll turn up. They're for the brown sedan parked outside the radio station. Oh, wait.
I probably shouldn't have said that. If anyone finds them, please don't steal my car. I mean, the old Hornbuckle mobile, please.
Oh, good. Here they are. Well,
never mind then.
Thank you
for listening to Second Moon.
Industry in the region is on the rise, and when business is doing well, that floats our boat.
There's no sinking this boat, Glenda. Local stargazers are in for a real treat tonight, as the Aurora Borealis is expected to light up the night sky.
That's right, Jim. Don't forget to look up this evening. It promises to be quite a sight.
Thank you.
Pending updates to our power grid, the city will be experiencing rolling blackouts. We urge the public to remain calm during these breaks in service and to follow the guidelines on the city's website on how to plan for these temporary events. This has been a local public service announcement. Recent spikes in demand have led to temporary local shortages in the city's fresh water supply. The public should be aware that we are struggling to get the situation in hand. This has been a local public service announcement.
That was truly superfluous. Masterful counterpart. You're listening to Second Moon Radio, the station of levitated tastes. Don't touch that dial.
For our feature story this hour, we're going live to Kim, who is downtown investigating the story behind our declining commercial zones. So, what exactly is driving this sudden downswing in business? Kim?
Good question, Glenda. I'm standing outside what used to be one of the busiest stores in the city. Not long ago, it would open its doors to lines of customers 7 days a week. Now the place is shuttered, like most of the commercial buildings on this once thriving city block. And the question on everybody's mind, how could it have come to this?
Thanks, Kim. We'll have more with Kim after the break.
And on to our main feature story. The commercial district is booming, as the area is attracting more high-end stores, bringing the latest in luxury to our neighborhood. You can now shop for designer shoes while sipping a fancy local Java mate, or so my wife tells me. That's good for business and good for the community.
Thanks, Jim. We'll be back after this.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special news bulletin.
Increasing areas of forest are being engulfed by flames. The thick smoke rising from the fire makes the air dangerous to breathe. Citizens are advised to vacate any premises near the fires and remain at a safe distance until emergency services manage to get the fires under control. A driving advisory has been issued for the immediate area due to poor road conditions. Please exercise caution if you must drive, and try to stay off the streets until conditions improve. This has been a local public service announcement.
That was truly superfluous. Masterful counterpart, you're listening to Second Moon Radio, the station of levitated tastes. Don't touch that dial.
We're live, and we're getting reports about a traffic accident somewhere in the city.
Road maintenance services have already been dispatched, and traffic flow should return to normal. But if you're planning a quick trip out, you might want to wait a little while until everything clears up.
If you're in it, you already know about it. No use reminding you. Meanwhile, respect delays and drive safe.
Industry in the region is on the rise, and when business is doing well, that floats our boat.
There's no sinking this boat, Glenda.